Hey everyone,
Alex here again. I played a lot of video games in 2019. Now granted, many of those games came out in 2019, but some of them didn't. Some of them came out in years that were not 2019. Yet I spent a lot of time with them, which I know is against the law, but I did it because I'm a criminal. So here are the old games I spent a lot of time playing in 2019. The Beatles Rock Band. 2019 marked the 10-year anniversary of a game that is very near and dear to my heart. Not because I'm the world's biggest Beatles fan or anything, but because Beatles Rock Band is probably the most significant project I've ever been a part of professionally. It's the game I count as most emblematic of my time spent working at Harmonix, and one of the things that I'm certainly most proud to have my name attached to, even if my contributions to its creation were almost entirely promotional in nature. It's a beautiful game that I think has held up better than nearly anything from the late aughts plastic instrument craze, and it was wonderful to revisit this year as a kickoff to our Extra Life nonsense. American Truck Simulator. Oh yeah, I'm still trucking along in 2019, which you probably already know if you've seen any of our various trucking streams on the site. 2019 marked the addition of Washington and Utah to the game, which absolutely both are states in the United States of America that have highways you can drive on. And I am driving on them, a lot. Mass Effect 2. Frequenters of Giant Bomb Premium Content trademark symbol probably caught at least an episode or two of 2019's hottest Giant Bomb Premium show, Mass Alex. Turns out those Mass Effect games are pretty good, especially Mass Effect 2, which, apart from a particularly goofy final boss fight, felt like a fantastic polishing of the many ideas laid down in the first game. I dig that first game a lot too, but the events of Mass Effect 2 have stuck with me throughout the year. Is it one of the best games of its generation? Yeah, I don't know. But it's a hell of a game, and I'm looking forward to finishing out the trilogy in the near future. Civilization VI. With Civilization VI, we are now the number of expansions deep it took for Civilization V to get really good. So, is Civilization VI really good? Yeah, not quite. 2019's Gathering Storm expansion is definitely the most substantive expansion for the game yet. And it's an addition of climate change and related disasters did enough to change up the flow of the game to get me playing it with much greater frequency. The first half of 2019 featured many more runs than I'd ever made time for in previous years, and adding a totally functional, if not ideal, Switch version inspired me to play a bit on the go, too. You should check out Civ 6. I swear I'm not saying this as I'm hovering over the Civ 5 play button on Steam. You should play Civ 6, and not 5. Definitely 6. Overwatch. All right, here's the thing. Overwatch did not get demonstrably better in 2019. It added things, it tweaked things, it remolded itself in the way Blizzard has been remolding this thing since it came out in 2016. I say all of this to demonstrate that there is absolutely no good reason why I got so heavily back into Overwatch this year of all years. I just did it. I don't understand why I like Overwatch so much. And I think that puts me in good company because it doesn't necessarily feel like the people who make Overwatch understand why people still play it either. The various pushes to turn Overwatch into a successful electronic sport have had zero effect on me, and under no circumstances have I ever cared enough about DPS or shield duration nerfs or whatever the hell that have come over the course of the years of updates to have any real feelings about them. Hell, I don't even really play many of the new characters. I still play two characters from the launch game almost exclusively. Like, yeah, I fuck with Wrecking Ball and Orisa and Moira here and there, but when there are still perfectly good Zenyatta and D.Va's sitting right there, why would I ever mess with anything else? And now we're staring down the barrel of Overwatch 2, a game that sounds like a pretty solid Overwatch expansion pack that I have no idea if I even care about all that much. I'll play it for the same reason I play Overwatch, because my brain is broken in a very specific way, and this game, either through intentional game design nefariousness or pure accident, is very good at exploiting the way in which my brain is broken. Good job, Blizzard? And folks, those are my favorite old games of 2019. You can play these old games right now on various platforms. You don't have to go back in time to play them. They're still there waiting for you. Thanks for listening.